الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة وكشف الله به الغمة فتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت وسلمت وباركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وارض اللهم عن ساداتنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن الصحابة أجمعين وعن التابعين وتابعيهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. Indeed, all praise is due to Allah. We praise Him. We thank Him. We seek His forgiveness and we seek His guidance. Whoever is guided by Allah, indeed he is guided. And whoever is left astray, for him you will find no guide and no supporter. I bear witness that there is no God except Allah, the one and only. And I bear witness that Muhammad is His final prophet and messenger. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon Prophet Muhammad and upon his family and upon his companions and upon those who followed them and those who follow them till the day of judgment. Allahumma ameen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us in the Quran, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. O you who believe, attain taqwa. Be aware of Allah as is worthy of Him and die not except in a state of Islam. My dear brothers and sisters, the blessings of Allah upon us are countless. It is one of the greatest blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He guided us to believe in Him. It is one of the greatest blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He guided us to be Muslim. It is one of the greatest blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are able to gather together today and pray Jum'ah. It is one of the greatest blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are alive to witness this blessed month of Ramadan. Imam Shafi'i, may Allah be pleased with him, said, Al-ibadatu mu'allalatun bimasalihi al-khalq. The acts of worship that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed for us are justified by the benefits of the worshippers, the benefits to the worshippers. Meaning when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed any act of worship for us, be it salah, sawm, zakah, hajj, umrah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave a reason for that, and that reason is our benefit. It is not to benefit Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether we all worship Him or none of us worship Him, it matters not to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It does not increase in His kingdom, in His dominion, nor does it take away from it if we turn away. All of these acts of worship, they were given to us for our benefit. And so it is important for us to understand, to realize why we do the things that we do. Many of us who, especially those of us who were born Muslim or grew up in a Muslim family or have been doing this for a long while, maybe we get into the habit of it, right? We pray out of habit, we fast out of habit. And we often overlook that benefit that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted us to get from these acts of worship. And so as we are, this is the first Jum'ah of Ramadan, my purpose today is just to remind all of us, inshallah, of why do we fast? Of why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed this fasting for us, and how can we get that benefit from it? And I'm sure by now you've heard this verse many times, and all of us have heard it before, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed the fasting. He said, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, O you who believe, fasting has been prescribed to you as it has been prescribed to those before you. The reason, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so that you may attain taqwa. And taqwa is a guard, it's a protection. You protect yourself from something harmful or something that could harm you. And so taqwa, in its linguistic meaning at least, you know, you ittaqi an-nar, ittaqi al-matar. That's what we say in Arabic. Guard yourself against fire, guard yourself against rain by carrying an umbrella and so forth. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us the reason for fasting is taqwa, is to establish that protection, to establish that guard between you and things that can harm you. And those things are many. Some of them are doubts that we may have in our mind. Some of them are sins that can lead us away from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so with this taqwa, with this protection that the fasting instills in us, we avoid doubt with certainty. We avoid shirk and worshipping other lords with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and replace it by tawheed and worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. We avoid sin and we guard against it by doing the obligatory acts of worship. And we avoid doubting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by knowing Him and knowing for sure that He has our best interest when He orders us to do something or to stay away from something else. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so that you may attain this taqwa. Imagine, my brothers and sisters, all of us today, I'm sure all of us are carrying a cell phone, right? And your cell phone, even if you're a little kid, the one of the first things you learn about it is that you need to recharge it. If you don't recharge it, it dies, it becomes a brick, it's useless. And so you know on a daily basis you need to get that charge. And even if you do that, eventually the battery weakens and you may have to replace it every once in a while. And even if you do that, eventually the phone gets old and you have to replace the phone completely. Our souls are no different, my dear brothers and sisters. We need that daily charge. And that comes from the prayers that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had prescribed for us. That comes from the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, calling on Him, praying to Him throughout the day and the night. And then we have gatherings like this, Jum'ah prayer, Jum'ah khutbah, that give us a bigger charge, a longer charge, that may carry us from Jum'ah to Jum'ah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the month of Ramadan, once a year, to get that boost to carry us the rest of the year. And then once in our lifetime, we need to replace everything. That's where Hajj comes in. When you do Hajj, عَادَ كَمَنْ وَلَدَتْهُ أُمُّهُ as the Prophet ﷺ told us, when you perform Hajj in its proper manner, you return as if you are brand new, as like the day your mother gave birth to you. And so these acts of worship are meant to benefit us, are meant to keep us on the straight path, are meant to bring us back every time we go astray, are meant to boost our hearts, boost our iman, give us that energy that we need to stay on the straight path so that we may attain the ultimate reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment in being among the righteous, being among the believers, being amongst the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the martyrs among those who enter Jannah inshallah. The Prophet ﷺ gave us the good news that if we were to use Ramadan the way it was prescribed for us, then the reward is plenty. The Prophet ﷺ said, "Man sama Ramadan imanan wahtisaban ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbih." Whoever fasts Ramadan with belief and seeking the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, meaning with the right intention. You fast because you believe it is a command from Allah. And you fast for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then what do you get in return? غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ. All your previous sins will be wiped out. Such a great reward that all of us are in need of. None of us can say they are sin-free. None of us can claim that they do not make mistakes. And none of us can say they do not need this reward. In a similar hadith, the Prophet ﷺ also said, "Man qama Ramadan," whoever prays the Qiyam and Ramadan, غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ, will also get that same reward. My dear brothers and sisters, Imam, the great Sahabi, Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him and his father, he said, ذِكْرُ اللَّهِ لَكَ أَيُّهَا الْمُصَلِّي أَكْبَرُ مِنْ ذِكْرِكَ لَهُ. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remembers you or mentions you, as we know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. When we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah remembers us and mentions us in a setting much better than the setting that we are in. And when we do that, Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him and his father, is saying what Allah is doing is much better, obviously, than what we are doing when we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِنَّكَ إِن ذَكَرْتَهُ أَدَّيْتَ وَاجِبَ الْعُبُودِيَّةِ. Because when we do it, when we remember Allah, when we worship Allah, when we mention His name, when we call upon Him, we are doing our duty that was prescribed for us as worshippers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when He subhanahu wa ta'ala, when Allah mentions us back, لَكِنَّهُ إِذَا ذَكَرَكَ مَنَحَكَ الْأَمْنِ. When Allah mentions you, what He does is that He gives you peace and tranquility in your heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَأَيُّ الْفَرِيقَيْنِ أَحَقُّ بِالْأَمْنِ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الْأَمْنُ وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. Allah is saying, those who believe and do not mix their iman with injustice, with transgression, for them is peace. لَهُمُ الْأَمْنُ وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. And they are guided. The scholars of the language say, by when Allah says أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الْأَمْنُ, by putting لَهُمْ before أَمْنُ, it means exclusively for them. If Allah said, أُولَٰئِكَ الْأَمْنُ لَهُمْ. If Allah said, peace is for them, in the Arabic language, it means that it's for them and it could be for others. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts and says, for them is peace, meaning it's only for them. That is the only way to achieve that peace, that tranquility, that satisfaction, that knowing what your purpose in life is by worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and doing what He asked us to do. My dear brothers and sisters, as we all know, as-siyam, fasting, is the worship of sincerity. It is the only worship where you cannot hide why you are doing it. Because when you are alone, and the food is there, and the drink is there, and no one is seeing you except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you can eat, you can drink. The only thing that's stopping you at that point is knowing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you. And so when you fast, it is the most obvious implementation or manifestation of what's in your heart. And that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the hadith that the Prophet ﷺ said, As-sawmu li wa ana ajzi bihi. Fasting is for me, hadith Qudsi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, as related in this hadith, fasting is for me and I reward for it. Allah kept the reward that He will give us in His knowledge, because He will reward to He will reward it immensely in a way that we cannot imagine, as long as we are doing it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to benefit from this month of Ramadan and to make us among those who are forgiven their sins and set free from the hellfire. Allahumma ameen. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum fastaghfiruh. فيا فوز المستغفرين استغفر الله استغفر الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى ثم أما بعد. My dear brothers and sisters, I'm going to conclude with this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, رَغِمَ أَنْفْ رَجُلٌ ذُكِرْتُ عِنْدَهُ فَلَمْ يُصَلِّي عَلَيْهِ وَرَغِمَ أَنْفُ رَجُلٍ دَخَلَ عَلَيْهِ رَمَضَانَ ثُمَّ انْسَلَخَ قَبْلَ أَنْ يُغْفَرَ لَهُ ورغم أنف رجل أدرك عنده أبواه الكبرى فلم يدخلاه الجنة. In this hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the person who is at great loss to the extent that he or she will be humiliated because of that loss. And he named three categories of people who this applies to them. Three opportunities to gain great rewards. And if we miss out on them, then we are among the biggest losers and among those who will be shamed and humiliated for their loss. The first is whoever hears the name of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and does not say sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The second is the person who reaches Ramadan and lives through Ramadan and then leaves Ramadan without being forgiven their sins. It's a great loss. And then the last category is people whose parents reach old age and they do not become a reason to go to enter you into paradise, meaning you ignore their service. You're not there to help them when they need you, just like they helped you when you needed them. If you miss that opportunity, you will also be among the great losers. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among the winners. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who listen to what is said and follow the best among it. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to maximize our rewards and to forgive our sins and to accept us among the righteous. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us in the Quran by saying, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. Allah and His angels send their peace and blessings upon Prophet Muhammad. O you who believe, send your peace and blessings upon him. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammad kama sallaita wa sallamta wa barakta ala Sayyidina Ibrahim wa ala ali Sayyidina Ibrahim fil alameen innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma aqsim lana min khashyatika ma tahulu bihi baynana wa bayna ma'asiyatik wa min ta'atika ma tuballighuna bihi jannatak wa min al-yaqeen ma تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا ومتعنا بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقواتنا ما أحييتنا واجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا وانصرنا على من عادانا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم لك الحمد حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وأقم الصلاة.